just in Kofi Annan is speaking our language with things, right from when Peter Tosh and the rest of them started talking about it. But for me, nobody on earth speaks about marijuana more than me. On radio, in the music, on stage, in drama, almost everywhere.
Tell us about marijuana.
For real, I mean, marijuana is an eating. The gold, the diamond, and the rest. The people out there have decided to bring down the prices and all that, and we are now suffering. So the in thing now is the marijuana thing that is, I mean, is going to help us make our economy stand fatter. That is all.
Is it just the economy or the usage or using aspect?
Well, in almost every aspect, because no matter how you use it, whoever you are sending it to is going to use it.
Okay.
You know, so marijuana in itself, we are late. It should be legalized right now. The creams, the shoes, the trousers, the shirts, the medicines, and I think we are playing the hypocrite. I mean,
what accounts for that level of increase? Because I even heard you say that there are some
Exactly.
What accounts for this?
Exactly. I mean, we are.
They don't call parliament, right?
Exactly.
What happened there?
Well, I went there and I told them straight away. They asked me if we'll set you free. Are you still going to talk about this? I said, yes, I'm so passionate about this marijuana thing. And it is legalized. Black Rasta will not rest. I mean, we have had an MP who went out there to sell marijuana. Marijuana and some other things were told. I mean, if you sit in parliament and say that this thing is not good and fight almost everybody and make people who use it look like demons, and then you will bypass them and go and sell it and make money and go and build your mansions. What are you playing? A hypocrite.
If you're a policeman and you're smoking,
arresting
the youth for smoking it too.
I mean, you are being a hypocrite straight. I mean, it is sad. But I think that we haven't been smart enough. Why was marijuana illegalized in the first place?
Tell us.
White people said that when their girls smoked marijuana, they became horny. They felt like sleeping with men. And then the men who were available immediately at that time were black people.
Yeah.
Therefore, I mean, this is something you can check. It's historical. I'm not making it up. So it was banned on a racist preamble in the first place. Number two, they banned it because the Caribbean countries were making so much money from this. Cigarette is legalized. Appetition is legalized. Butu is legalized. All these
factors are legalized.
I mean, and marijuana cannot be what? Legalized? Remember that the professor who is talking right now about the legalization of marijuana, me and him were at the Parliament House.
He was there
for Ebola. You know where to?
Tionubeka Ebola said,
good.
And then you went to talk about
marijuana. So there we decided to talk about it, and then so the fight is on.
You have influenced him?
Well, I think so.
Black Rasta?
Yeah. Ushimi. Minshin, I've never smoked it. You see, people just look at marijuana as something that you just smoke. But here, no, you can use it for so many different things.
It's just, shit.
Dabi.
But what do you get different things?
Different things.
Dabi. It means you shoot different ways.
Different ways. Shoe, say. You see, there are
creams on the market. Shoe,
yes. To canvas, near trout, jeans, near it. And even Kuza, Ewa market.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, KUZA.
Yeah.
100 is written on it, embossed. 100% Indian hemp.
A shoe.
100% Indian.
And all that.
You know, so the marijuana fight has to go on. That's why we said Kofi Annan has. You see, and the thing Kofi Annan has made the people understand is the fact that all the countries that have legalized marijuana
are making money out of
apart from the money they are making out of it, the use of marijuana in those countries has even gone down. Crime rate has gone down. Look at Holland. They are closing down their jailhouses for lack of prisoners. But it's very legal there. Go to California.
It's a tourist attraction. People go to red light
districts. Exactly.
In Holland to
make cash, you see. So where we have something that is illegal, more people want to be adventurous. They want to get into that, and they know but where it is legal, human psychology tells you that where something is legal, people are freer, and a lot of people might not even go into it.
So the usage will come down.
Yes.
And it will bring down criminality.
Exactly.
On the
down.
Issue as well. You have made a song on this.
Yes, Kofi Annan says.
And I want the Black Rasta says.
Kofi Annan, say make we legalize it. Too long in a Ghana legalize the ganja. Legalize it. Stop the begging. Stop the stealing. Number two, legalize it. Eh?
These are the lyrics in the song.
Yes. Let the economy grow. You see, these are the lyrics of the song.
You think this is going to have an impact on
it's already making waves all over.
Policy making in terms of
seriously.
Legalizing marijuana.
This week I'm going to meet with the president. I've already arranged things.
Oh, she's
a
president.
Yes.
And then I'll
give
you
a copy of this.
Hey,
and then I'll give you a whole document. Because at the end we are check, we are suffering. India has come to give us 30
million. What are you going to tell the president?
To tell the president, say, at the end, we have been fighting for it. And to Mr. President, take your time now. Free HSS has happened. Galamsey is happening. Take your time and look at the ganja aspect too. And trust me, within a few months, when this thing is legalized, we wouldn't need to go and queue for visas to go where. We'll be okay in our country. Like they are in South
Africa. What have you been up to? You left your radio.
I've been lecturing in America.
You lectured in schools.
Yeah, some universities.
Some universities.
Yeah,
should have
been. Yeah, University of Central Missouri. You know, I was a resident scholar there.
Wow.
And then I also lectured in the University of North Carolina.
Were you telling them about marijuana?
Well, when the opportunity brought itself, I did. When I taught Africana studies, world religions, world history, you know, all these things.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I've been doing a lot of things in the background, but the good news is that I'm returning on radio next month.